Welcome to the videos, Linus. Muslim Shmuel Baruch and Chaim Sidoiv. Good vacht, everyone. Let's start off with some chizuk from Shabbos Kodesh. I think it was the Shvasemus of Imre, but he says, you know, Rashi says that Yaakov Avinu was fighting with the angel of Esav. And then at some point, the angel says, I gotta leave. Whoa. So Yaakov says, what do you mean? We're having a great fight here. He was wrestling. Pashup Shat. So it says that he said, listen, I gotta go sing. Sing. Right now, we're busy having the most monumental fight, obviously a very deep fight. We're presenting such an incredible battle, and you gotta leave because you have to go sing. There's other times to sing. What's pshat? What's even the singing going on? So I think maybe it's Fasemis, maybe it's a cousin Shemagid. I forget who says this. Yesoid. He says no. An angel, is tachlis, his job. We get angels sent to us all the time. In fact, every one of us is walking around with two angels. So much so that it actually put down in halacha the person before he goes to the bathroom, he should say iskabdu mechubadim, my honored guests, or my honored messengers, wait, because I got to go to the bathroom. Now the minhag is not to say this anymore because who says necessarily that we have? It's like a little bit of a gaiva de kazim, but etzem, it's a powerful idea that we have an angel with us, two angels with us all the time. Yitzhari, Yitzhar Toiv. Anyway, so the angels are there for what? The angels are there, especially the angel of the Yitzhara. Etzim is not a bad guy. He's a good guy. Why? Because he's there to give us a struggle. Many angels are created just for a purpose, and once that purpose is fulfilled, that's it. They finished. They puff away. Some angels stay around. Some of them puff away. Those that puff away is when their tachlis, the purpose, it was fulfilled. This angel was saying, was teaching us an incredible lesson. When an angel has fulfilled his mission of giving us a struggle, and we stood that struggle, ki sarisa yim elokim, you were able to fight. It doesn't say that he took him down. You know, in wrestling, there's different ways of what's called pinning. It doesn't say necessarily that he pinned the angel down. He was able to go up. The struggle itself, to be able to stand, withstand the struggle, that itself is a reason to sing. And the angels was teaching us, now I could go sing to the Rabbeinu Shlomo. My purpose was fulfilled. An incredible deep message, because so many times we struggle and we think, oh my gosh, this is so difficult, this is so bad. The fact that a person is able to struggle, that itself is a celebration. And another chiddush, I think maybe this is Fasemus, the Imre Emes, he says, no, and Vetuchal doesn't say that you killed it. You were able to withstand, to take the struggle and say, Rabbi Hashem, you're sending me the struggle, I'm going to do the best I can in this wrestling match. That itself is a reason for Shira. Okay, let's go now to Halacha. We're going to start already the Halachas Chanukah. We're getting very close. One of the most important Halachas and the most popular Halacha and maybe the most profitable Halacha in the bakery industry is the donuts. Is there a mitzvah to eat donuts? So first of all, there's a mitzvah to do anything, according to the Chasam Sofer, mitzvah de oraisa, to do anything that is publicizing the miracle. And therefore, eating a donut for the sake of Chanukah, to remind us of the miracle of Chanukah. Now, why do you eat donuts? One of the reasons is because it's filled with oil. So now, do we have to go crazy? No. How many donuts do you have to eat? 8 a day, 7 a day, 6 there you go, but based on the days, first day one, second day two, second day three. By the eighth day, was the 8 donuts. That's what some people think. But really, what you could do is my simple suggestion: take a donut, one large donut, divide it into 8 pieces, and each day eat one piece. And there's a hoisafet. There's the additional part. There's you can even put a candle. There's enough oil in each one of those pieces to last for 8 days. So why is it that we're having these donuts? It's because of the oil. To remind us of the Shemen, the miracle of Chanukah. So anything that we do to publicize the miracle is actually could be a mitzvah d'oraisa going to the Chasam Sefer. So it's a beautiful thing to eat a donut. But since we're speaking about the donut, there's also an interesting shaila. Anytime you eat what's called pas haba b'kisnin, something that is what's called mezoinos, pas haba b'kisnin, different definitions of what that means. But it means it's not bread. So why is something not bread? Either it's because it's a snack, or it's because it's filled, or because the dough is made with something else. Here, what's interesting is that the donut, if you're a baker, and I was speaking to a baker about this, someone that knows this stuff, that donut never even goes through a baking stage. It's basically fried in oil. That's what it's fried. It's fried in oil. And therefore, what's the chiddush? The chiddush is that since it's not baked, it actually doesn't have a din of a suda, meaning to say, there's an advantage and a disadvantage. The advantage is that usually when a person has what's called pasabav kisni, which means a real mezoinus, so let's say cookies or cake, which was baked, went through a baking stage. If you have too much of it, which is the equivalent of about 3 or 4 eggs, which there would be, each egg is about Each kezais is about 25 grams, so that means 50 grams is one egg. Three times that is 150 grams, or around 200 grams. If you're eating too much of mezoinos, you have to bench. You're going to have to say kamoitzi. When it comes to donuts, that's not true. You can eat as many donuts as you want, then you still won't have to bench. So that's good, and it's not so good, because it's a dangerous thing. But what another interesting thing is, there's some poskim say, therefore, really, you can't be yitzeh. Some say that just like when it comes to, let's say, Yerushalmi kugel. Same idea. Yerushalmi kugel is not something that you actually bake. Since you don't bake, really, it's something that you're not really kaveh suda, so maybe you can't even be yitzeh kiddush b'makom suda on Shabbos. Now, this is a very interesting shaila. But the ma'isa, alocha le'ma'isa, let's just summarize. A donut is a special food, especially Chanukah time. Before, there's no mitzvah. On Chanukah time, there's a mitzvah, and it's a reminder of the miracle, and it's something to remind us of the Shemen, and we have to think about it, and we have to praise the bunch of it. And number two, eat 1/8. You eat it already, that's a kezais. And number three, a person doesn't have to worry about the Birkas Hamazon aspect, but it's good to remember this halacha, because when it comes to certain foods, mezoinous foods, a person will have to bench if they eat too much. Have an amazing day.